Okay, thanks, Uncle Mighty. A nice one be that. All right, ladies and gentlemen, now we go talk about particularly the symptoms of type 1 diabetes mellitus. Okay, we will talk about what be the symptoms. And as I mentioned the last time, we get the following symptoms. We get polyphagia. We get glucosuria. We get polydipsia. And we get polyuria. Okay? Now, make I explain why we get all these conditions. Now, the first thing we say, now, remember, say this type 1, we say the body no they produce. Now produce a lot of or enough insulin will go help us move our glucose from inside our blood into our cell. So now what thing will happen, we say now the body will come try to compensate, you understand, and the process of that compensation, the body will come lead to the production a lot of lipolysis. You understand? Lipolysis and also proteinolysis. You understand? So what in this lipolysis and proteinolysis? Let me say that they break down of a lot of fats inside the body. You understand? And also the lot of proteins. A lot of proteins will come break down into the body. That one are the process of gluconeogenesis and of course the process of glycogenolysis. Now it will come happen here. You understand? So it can lead to a lot of breakdown. So now what thing will happen? The person will come there, we can lose weight. So what thing will happen? The person will come like to one eat. Because by the time your body they try compensate, to try to, you know, to try to break down, to produce a lot of glucose so that your body fits for survive, you know, it will make you lose weight. Because lipolysis now fat could come off for a lot of part of your body, weight could come go down. You understand? That one night, then they call lipolysis. Then you will come there hungry and you come like to eat a lot because you lose weight and you know, and you they weak and you need more food. So, poly means a lot, phagia means eat, hunger. You understand? Now that thing they can't cause this polyphagia. Do you understand me now? Should you understand me? Now, the next one now, glucosuria. Now, glucose, you need to know, say, glucose, they osmotically active. What it means, say, they osmotically active? We say, you know what it means, osmosis, what we say, now, the movement of solvent, you understand, from area of lower concentration to area of high concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. So, glucose, they very osmotically active. So, what thing will happen now? Since a lot of glucose, they inside the blood, so when it they filter through the kidney, you know, when they filter through the kidney, what thing they can happen? A lot of glucose will come they drop inside urine. You understand? So you will come see a lot of glucose for urine. The normal urine, piss. And then they call urine for English. So glucose will come there inside urine. As it is osmotically active, water will come they follow them. It will come they go inside the you know, urine. Now, maybe they can't get a lot of glucose, urea. So, you can see glucose inside urine. Now, the next thing we say now, polydipsia. Polydipsia means, say, if they drink a lot of, you know, water, a lot of water. Why if they drink a lot of water? Obviously, now, because of, say, as this person, they urinate a lot, polyuria, you know, because this one go cause this one to happen. Now, so as the person they urinate a lot, you they urinate a lot of water. You understand? And why you go urinate a lot? You go urinate a lot because as glucose they osmotically active, if they draw water, they come close to them. You understand? So water will come, they move towards glucose, come they come out. So the person go they urinate a lot. As the person urinate a lot, person go come day without fluid for body. So as the person day without fluid for body, person go come feel like say he need to drink more water, and he go come like to drink a lot of water because in they dehydrated. Then as the person they dehydrated, that thing will come make and drink a lot of water, and then they call polydipsia. Should be understand me now? Let me make I take them again. Polyphagia, now say a lot of eating. Now, because of say the person would they weak, lose weight, because they would do a lot of breaking down, a lot of catabolic processes will go lead to breakdown of fat. Catabolic na kata na heavy catabolic process. Lot of kata for system where they break down a lot of things. Now that thing will come cause person go eat more. At that eating more, help polyphagia. Glucose, you will be say glucose now, since a lot of them they for blood vessels. So when they filter for kidney, it go they come inside urine. So you go to see them. Now, polyuria be say the person go like to urinate more. Why? Because as glucose they enter inside urine, it they carry a lot of water, you know, because glucose they osmotically active. So water will come they follow and water come they follow. So polyuria. Now this polyuria will come cause person to drink water more because person go they what? Dehydrated. Dehydrated, another one they talk say water no day. Hydrated, hydro, water no day, no water, no nothing. And body no fit stay without water because body no be firewood. My children they talk. So now these things be the major symptoms where person go see for diabetes type 1. So once you see this particular thing, you're going to say this person get a little bit of the symptoms of diabetes type 1. So now we'll quickly move over to waiting the particular unique complication for this diabetes type 1. And that unique complications now waiting be the bad thing where they happen for diabetes type 1, where they very common to diabetes type 1. Now that one that they call DKA. DKA. DKA, I don't know what it is here. DKA means saying diabetic ketoacidosis. Ketoacidosis. So it means say now, because of a lot of fatty acid breakdown, the liver go come convert that fatty acid into what they call ketone bodies. Ketone bodies now acetoacetate, you know, hydroxybutyric acid, you understand, and even acetone. You understand? So these are now they call ketone bodies. And you remember, say these ketone bodies, then they are acidic. You understand? Because these ketone bodies will help for the body to give energy. Now make liver, they convert, you know, fatty acid into ketone bodies. So when they a lot in the blood, they go cause a lot of acidosis. And that acidosis, they very bad. Because when your body, they a lot of acid. Now, waha, na be that. And the wahala go day like bicycle. So now the problem that so this DKA now diabetic ketoacidosis we go increase the amount of acid you know level where they for blood will cause a lot of problem. One of the things where you go see because of diabetic ketoacidosis now that will cause mouth breathing. Cause mouth breathing. Now why we go get cause mouth breathing? We'll be deep and labored breathing. The reason you go get them is say now a lot of acid therefore inside your blood. So your body will want to try to remove a lot of CO2. CO2 now they call carbon dioxide. Now this carbon dioxide, now we go to they breathe out. Then we breathe in oxygen. That one will they breathe out carry a lot of what? Acidic content. So your body will like to take them out. You know, to just help. You know, they go try for this our body. Anytime we wahala day, your body somehow will try to what take care of them. You understand? And so you go try to breathe them out. So you go there to their labored and deep breathing. That is they call cosmal respiration. Now, apart from cosmal respiration, your body will still get a lot of other similar things like this. You know, we go also affect the body. This same organ like this. It cause you nausea, you know, one of the complications, nausea. If it cause vomiting, if you also cause acute cerebral edema, even cause mental, you know, instability and some other issues, we will discuss in detail in the next slide, waiting and waiting, you feel do to prevent this. But before we go there, we would like to talk about type 2 diabetes. We will be our next slide. We'll explain waiting with this type 2 diabetes, how this one they different from type 1, and how we forfeit handle this situation before we talk about the other different types of diabetes. So, my dear, you go see, say, this topic, now very important topic. I want to make you work out gently with me. Come into the next slide. Make we talk about type 2 diabetes. Then we'll talk about how all these things will carry fit so. Fam, thank you. Make I see you next slide.